everyone has their own story of how they got into comics, and this is mine. Hey guys, it is Tristan, and yeah, that's me, for today at least, and I want to tell my story. I've had a few requests to talk about why and how I got into comics, and I'm finally addressing it. So I grew up state to state, house to house, with a terrible mother and an even worse father. Life on the day-to-day wasn't always easy. I didn't have a television in my room. I didn't have cell phones like kids have today. So when my father left, he left something behind that would forever change my life. My very first comic book. That began a lifelong journey of reading and writing, learning more, and wanting to know everything, all with one book. And that book was Batman: Death in the Family. But I wanted more. I wanted to know more. So I started to go to my local library. I found everything I could possibly want. Books beyond books, pages beyond pages. But they didn't have much comics back then. So I wanted to find a way to actually buy them for myself. Besides, the library was a good mile away, and walking alone at 6 or 7 wasn't something I particularly enjoyed doing. Let's talk about school. At school, I was very odd. Awkward, standoffish. I had a hard time speaking, and an even harder time socializing. I never made conversation with anyone first. But then a little girl came to me. Her name was Grace. She always had friends and people around her, but she wanted me. She needed one more person to play X-Men. And this was during a time that the animated show X-Men was very popular. And they needed a rogue. I became Rogue, but not just any rogue. I was the best rogue in the tri-state area, let me tell you. And Rogue, she quickly became my favorite character. But more importantly, Grace became the most important person in my life for the next 10 plus years. It was sort of foreign to me, right? The first time I ever spent the night at Grace's house, we were allowed to go to the comic book shop with her dad. And we got our very own X-Men book. I thought I was in heaven. I'll never forget waking up feeling so excited. I'll never forget that feeling of walking in. I was never allowed anything new or really much at all. And this girl, she made my life complete. I mean, as complete as it can get for a 10-year-old, but she would sneak food to me when I needed her. Her parents gave me a warm bed and safe haven. They never judged. They always let me stay and play with Grace as long as I needed. We spent months playing X-Men, eventually switching over and graduating to playing TLC. While reading X-Men, I never understood back then why they always made me the crazy one. I believe her name was Left Eye. I kind of get it now. But anyways, one day Grace was sick. I went to recess and I was reading in this little wooded area that I normally went to, and a boy from class decided to come over to me. His name was Corey. He asked me if we wanted to read each other's books. A simple thing like this started a tradition that lasted through middle school of trading books, mostly Batman, X-Men, definitely Superman, and we got to read twice the material that we would have before. Now, comics were always an escapism for me. I had a box in my closet of my books, and I would use my flashlight to read while I hid from my mother and her onslaught of meth-induced paranoia. But even when I couldn't escape into my books, I could escape into my mind. There was so many times when I'd be dealing with my mother and her abusive rampages and pretend to be Batman. It was my way of going to a little place in my mind that was strong and unable to be hurt. A little piece of me knew that Batman always came back, always prevailed. And by pretending, I would then too. Until one day in high school, when I got a call. And it was that Grace had fallen asleep at the wheel. Grace was an athlete. She always had been an athlete, and she was coming back from a softball tournament. She had pushed herself to the point of exhaustion, and that was it. I've had a lot of darkness in my life, but that loss is something I will never, ever be able to shake. Now, more than anything, it taught me more about myself than I knew at that time, or maybe even needed to know. I needed to know that escapism is okay. To want to lose yourself in a world unlike your own is normal. It is the basis of almost all entertainment. Comics can mean something different to everyone. But what matters is that they mean something. I think that's what most don't understand when I talk about the downward trend in quality or the change in pre-established characters. It is because since I could, I have loved reading and absorbing information. I've loved digging deeper and finding new Easter eggs. It's always something that I will love. It's something I still love. Many look forward to the latest blockbuster or the newest TV show. I look forward to new comic book day. There's something bigger about superheroes than we even see. It's intense visuals and a focus on plot and characters, yes, but it's much more engaging than other media. It provides a relief from thinking about normal, everyday troubles, but also it serves as a way to inspire. Now, books like Superman make you want to be your best self. You can always look back and ask, what would I do in this given situation? It allows for reflection of our own lives through and having new vicarious experiences. We see the trials of superheroes and sometimes draw parallels to our own lives, and we seek to be inspired. Some part of each of us is still searching for that one piece that will make the rest of our lives whole, the rest of our lives work. And sometimes it's uncovered through reading and reflection. I like, of course, the juxtapose of words and images that one can indeed enhance the other, bringing a whole different meaning than one could on its own. A narration can be fine and moving all by itself, but a picture can provide new or even unexpected context when they're joined together. As Neil Gaiman pointed out, you can do anything with words and with pictures. Comics also can play in a different manner than films can, right? They allow the reader to absorb the effects of the images and not have the awkward silences that might affect a film badly, especially when it comes to time travel. And it's always made open to interpretation. It's how you feel about it. It is not told what it is. I like the history, of course, of the art form as well, often with creators having a lot of single month, a lot to do every single month with a very small budget, making often unreasonable deadlines that drove some crazy, crazy innovative storytelling techniques. And the experimentation that came about because of it. Each artist or writer then trying to outdo the one that came before them. In the early days of mainstream comics, these people were creating things that had huge, massive, deep effects on our culture today. But it was just simply a job. It's amazing to think about. Casually, then they would toss off iconic images and concepts with no deep, real introspection or repeated edits or hand-wringing about them, whether it was good enough or whether it wasn't. Deadlines were hard, and you didn't get more work if you could not hit them, and you had to keep sales up. The history of it is also fascinating because it's changed so much since then. Along with the history, of course, there is always that bit of love because of nostalgia. It's the only art form I've ever seriously followed and done real, true, deep dives into, not just the history, but how they were made, who the personalities were behind the art form, their influence on the mainstream, and more recently, their acceptance into the mainstream, the creative process behind making comics, the way the industry operated and continues to evolve in a modern era, and I still enjoy every minute of it. I've enjoyed the art form so much, I did cosplay for a long time, and basically since then, have a whole channel dedicated to this art form to review, to talk about the news surrounding it, and to show my love for geek culture, something that has definitely become more popular as it's introduced into the mainstream. Now that I've told my story, I want to know yours. Let me know in the comments below why you specifically got into comics, why you love comics, or why you don't read them anymore. Anything below is appreciated. I read each and every single comment you leave and often try to reply, not every time, but I do try when I have a moment free. So let me know in the comments below. Of course, as always, like and subscribe. If you are new to the channel, I make content every single day. I will see you guys in the next one. Bye-bye.